Harrison, I wonder if you look back first.
How crazy was the wind in that game at Buffalo? You had a kick that you kicked all the way through the end zone. You couldn't make it all the way. Just what was the wind like for you guys?
Yeah, it was tough. I guess the wind wasn't super intense. I think the game against the Dolphins, the wind was higher, but the Bills stadium is definitely lower. So that wind was coming like from the west, I think. And because their stadium's so low, we were experiencing all of that wind. Whereas if you have a stadium like Arrowhead or a bigger stadium, the wind's coming from way up high and then it's dipping down and it's kind of swirling more. So I haven't played a game where there was wind like that hard one direction in a while, but I think it was kind of because of the configuration of the stadium. But, you know, it was tough going that direction. I think Tony Romo mentioned that I missed, you know, from like 51 or 52 short in warm-up. Like, we were both struggling, Tyler Bass and myself. But our range going that direction was a 48-yarder, so 47. It was just enough, and you can see on the network broadcast, I'm checking to see if it went over the crossbar, but it did.
Yeah, Harrison, that first field goal going that way, you're usually the first guy to know whether it's going through, but it looked like you didn't know until the referee raised his arms. Was that the case?
No, definitely, because I was concerned about the distance, and it was kind of tailing a little left. And I guess my main concern was, is it going to make it that far? And then also, because the ball's dying with its velocity, you know, so early in the kick, is it going to just completely cut left and go left? And, yeah, thankfully it didn't, but I wanted to make sure the referees put both arms up.
How much have you admired Justin Tucker over the course of your career? You guys have been kind of right there, back and forth, battling.
Right.
To be the best kicker in the league. But how much have you admired him to see it?
Yeah, so, you know, I think Tucker's on year 12. I'm on year 7, so he's got – fact check me. He's got more years than I do. But I remember when I was in college, at least, you know, just on YouTube, and I guess probably even senior year of high school, going on YouTube and seeing his you know, he posted one workout where he's in his Texas, you know, clothes out in their stadium, and he's just, you know, hitting 10 kicks in a row, moving the tripod around and just watching his form, and then seeing – you know, when he replaced Billy Cundiff for the Ravens and how he came in as a rookie free agent guy and really made, you know, a big difference for their team. And I don't know what the career field goal percentage was when he came in the league, probably, I don't know, around 86 or so. And then boom, he's at 90 plus and he's stayed there for such a long career. No injuries. He makes it look effortless. And I think he's really kind of changed the kicking game. And yeah, pushed it forward, which is great. So now all of us young kickers, we have, you know, someone we can look to and say, you know, it is possible to make these 65-yard field goals and, you know, make these big game-winning kicks. But it is cool to see a kicker that's kind of an artist, and he dances after, and he just does a lot of stuff that's very different than most other kickers. But, yeah, he's done an amazing job in his career.
Like quarterbacks don't play each other on the field at the same time. What's it really like to have the opportunity to go against him in a game that may come down to kicks?
You know, every time I feel like we play the Ravens, you know, people will talk about Tucker. And I think the best thing for me to do is just focus on, you know, my warm up and doing the best I can to prepare myself for the game. And then when the game comes, you know, just focused again on me and making whatever opportunities come my way. But almost as a fan of Tucker and of kicking, I'm going to want to watch him. But I've learned, all right, I can't do that. I just got to focus on what I'm doing. And then after the game, be able to talk with him, pick his brain.
Being a fan of kicking, okay. Did you reach out to Tyler Bass and express any support?
No, I actually didn't reach out to him at all. It was unfortunate. I'm just trying to give him some time away, probably to clear his head from kicking and kind of enjoy the off season a little bit. But I'll probably text him later on this off season. He's a guy that went to Georgia Southern, so I've kicked with him in the off seasons, him and Youngway Koo, and he's a great kicker, and I really think he does a great job, but just giving him a little space right now. And it's tough because as a kicker, you know, you're going to have games like that where you miss a kick, and, you know, ideally it's not in a big game, but you can prepare and do everything you can, but sometimes, you know, the cards just don't fall in your favor, and that's why it's so important to remain humble, because it can happen to any of us, you know.
Harrison, this season, I mean, you've been so consistent for such a long haul, and I wonder if it's talking about the middle game, is there anything particular this season that has enhanced your focus or made you stronger, made you better than ever? What would that be?
I think it's a lot of different things that have helped. I think physically I'm feeling really, really good. I'm prioritizing sleep. Family life is going really well with my wife and children. I think there's a lot of balance when I come into the facilities. And when I'm here, I'm able to attack and do my best. And I feel like that's just helped me be consistent, I'd say. I think on game day, I've done a really good job of staying locked in and focused on what I can control and not worrying about anything else. But also, I say this a lot, I can do everything to prepare for the game throughout the week, throughout the off season. But when I go out there, it really does feel like, you know, God can make that ball go in or he can make it not go in. So the difference between having a season where you're 94% and maybe, or 84%, it's just a couple of misses and it could be just some freak things that cause the ball to go in or don't go in. And I'm very thankful to have made all of those kicks. And again, I don't think it's all me. There's definitely something else that's helping.
Last one.
Do you pay attention to the weather reports? Do you worry because they change day to day? For instance, they're saying it may rain or it may not. Do you follow that stuff at all during the week?
Definitely. I think as a kicker, your competition is kind of the surface you're playing on and the weather. So things I look at are, is it going to be sunny? And then if it's going to be sunny, what's the stadium configuration? Because you need to know where the shadows are going to be. That's something that's always affected me, especially if the holder maybe his shadow is causing where the ball's going to go to be really dark. So, you know, when the ball gets put down, I'm not going to be able to see it. Or the holder could put the ball down and you can see the ball and then your shadow goes over the spot and then the ball turns dark right before you make contact. Obviously, if it's raining, you need to make sure you have good cleats that you can wear. And then wind as well. You need to know, okay, if this is going to be a day where there's going to be a lot of right to left, I need to make sure I'm working with my holder on, for me at least, for leaning the ball away from me towards him. If it's left to right, obviously it needs to be straight up and down. You got to work on starting at left, but you just try to make sure you're prepared. So you've won the game before you even begin. And there's no surprises when you get to the stadium, you know, okay, the wind's going to do this, shadows, you know, rain or shine, you're kind of ready. And I think that helps keep you calm no matter what the situation is.
Thanks, everybody.
All right. Thank you.